So Harley Davidson wanted something really great created from their scrap. The finished looking piece was so impressive. They could not realize that it is their scrap which has been used and put it again in the showroom. I watched Transformers movie and I was so inspired by that when I actually came out of the theater, I could relate scrap metal parts coming together and making an entire big robot out of it. Hi, my name is Priyang Langparia. I make sculptures, murals, etc. only with scrap. I used to pick up things from the roadside. Anything that looked shiny, looked different, like small metal balls, for example. One day, I had this entire drawer full of scrap. And I was told by my parents that please throw it because we need to keep something else. We need to utilize that particular storage. That's the time when I was like, no, this is interesting. And there's one reason why I picked up these parts and why I preserved them till now. That's how I started joining them together. And I joined and I created a lot of pieces. Automobile parts have always fascinated me. Are already in different shapes. There are different holes, there are different chamfers, there are different fillets, there are different gears available, there are different thicknesses available. So a bearing for me is an eye and a clutch plate is a part of a chest. So that's the way I see scrap and the potential in which those parts can be used. And mainly I make pieces with them. So I'll give you a nice instance about my latest project. So there was this client who needed a yin-yang concept. So he wanted the positive and the evil side both supporting each other. So that's how I came up with the idea of presenting the evil element as the dragon and the good element as the Mother Earth, green nature, etc. Since the essence of the dragon lies in its curves, so there were various curves which were sketched out freehand. Once we got the right curve, and once we make the entire piece, for example, that we made right now, then the post-processing part is discussed with the client again. We would generally go with contrast colors, which make the mural stand out in terms of the entire composition of the space. And that's how the piece is then installed and we move ahead with it. When I walk around the scrapyard, I see parts just lying around, lifeless, dead. These parts come together and give a nice structure and form a meaning to it.